Welcome back, YouTube gamers. This is Aero from N2 Mobile Games, bringing some more Clash Royale. We are in the final days of our oppression at the hands of extremely crappy mortar players. I mean, don't get me wrong, we'll get new players that'll try hard super hard, and, you know, we'll have to adapt to them too. But with the upcoming patch notes, you know, we're hopefully not going to see nearly as much of this as we have up to this point. The game for today is see how many mortar players I have to fight, and so that I can appreciate never having to do this ever again. Mind you, there'll still be the mortar strategy out there. It'll probably evolve. It'll probably change. It just probably won't be basically the go-to for somebody who looked up how to be a legendary, like, player by getting into, you know, Legendary Arena because you used this strategy because, you know, statistically it's a good deck. Who would have thought? Anyway, this is my deck as always. I shouldn't say always. I haven't changed anything in a couple of streams. I'm liking it. I've been working on it. I've been trying to level up my cards. For those of you who are having difficulty leveling up your cards and you are not in a clan, I highly advise you to join one. The point of clans is to basically throw cards back and forth and, you know, as I said, encourage it heavily. It's one of the easiest ways to help you basically grow your deck, especially if you've got cards you like playing with and you actually want to, like, you know, put in some work. Well, we'll get started. I got a crown chest. I'm in the right under the 2300 range, and we should be having not too hard of a time. This is about the middle of where my my play arena is, and, you know, so we'll see what we get. Ups and downs. What's going on, King? I see you just jumped in. It's awesome. But yeah, the game for the day is see how many mortar players I run up against. Maybe none. That would be hilarious. So, there we go. We don't have a lot to actually stop this. We can just basically kill it. That's the best we got. Now, I think we're just going to have to take that on the chin, unfortunately. What we're going to do is basically reverse push. If we can get some decent action out of this, it'll be totally worth it. Spear Goblins are who we're trying to basically force to do the most damage here. So far, we're not doing too disastrously. We'll see how this works out. They throw anything else, and I'm gonna totally poison it. There it goes. Oh, that's... Anyway, it's unfortunate. So, Valkyrie comes out, she takes out my gobs, I'm still doing okay. We gotta be conservative with our elixir right now. They should be above us as far as maximum potential. So let's play smarter, not harder. This should be an okay matchup. Baby dragon should at least live with a little bit of HP, question mark? No? Oh well. Tower didn't take any damage. I'm okay with that. As I said, we're trying not to overplay our hand. We're doing just fine on their left tower. They could easily take that back from us if they were smart. Hog Rider should be coming out sometime soon. The likelihood that Hog Rider comes out with that Musketeer is really high. Wait for it. Anyway, so that's going to be a blowout. There's our Hog Rider. We'll make this really, really easy for ourselves. And then Dark Prince is going to go and tank for us. I think that bomb tower is totally going to get all my guys. If not, their Valkyrie will. So we already know what we're running up against. Baby Dragon right here will make my life very easy. Still honestly pretty easy. Good value for the card. We're going to go and throw down Giant Skeleton. He should basically stop this. Didn't go fast enough to actually stop the Musketeer. I think I've been honestly playing poorly against that lately. And so we're going to really want to try to play better against that is the only way to say it. We're going to need as much poison as we can muster off of this. They've got basically the defensive structure advantage right there. We're going to need to really put that into the ground if we want to have a chance of being able to take down their tower. Once again... It's Spear Goblins is what we're looking for on the driving force here, but unfortunately it's going to get blocked pretty hard. And we're going to take some serious damage because of it. If we can save this tower, we can totally counter-push. It's just the question is, can we save this tower? And the answer is no, we cannot. If they let me take this, that's awesome. They should not be letting me take this, is the only way to say this. It literally has 1 HP. Literally 1 HP. Oh my god. I'll take it. So, this is the slow death. If they have arrows, I lose. But if not, I win! Anyway, my deck's expectations do always go down to basically a clincher at the end because it's not especially great at any one thing other than jumping on people. You know, that lives up to its name. That's honestly been my opinion of my deck. I have to play it well or I lose. And when I play it well, then I win. And that's the sort of deck I want to play with because it encourages me to play well. Who would have thought? Crazy. And then so same problem we had last time, except we have freeze this time. We'll fare better, honestly. Dark Prince is gonna live through this. We're gonna hog ride that. We have poison. We don't have freeze. They're throwing all sorts of garbage our way. That's fine. We'll throw poison. It's not really gonna help us get anything to the tower. It's just gonna dematerialize their defenses. And we'll have to go on defense ourselves, just because poison's not exactly cheap. There's Hog Rider. I swear he... Anyway. So, we'll deal with that. That's a lot of Hog Rider real fast. That's eventually going to catch up to us because, quite honestly, you either have freeze or you have the tower to defend against him in my deck. So that's what we got. Yeah, Knight hits a little bit harder than I remember. Okay. And then freeze is the only thing that's going to save that tower. I assume they're also going to freeze. We'll find out. They did not. Hog Rider's actually okay behind a giant skeleton. It's not surprising. They're basically throwing out defenses. Bomb's basically going to go down, do nothing. Knight's going to hit him like twice and he's going to die. I didn't get much action off of that either. We should probably save that. Spear Goblins will go down. Knight will have to deal with it. Sidestep the fireball. That's not honestly all that surprising. And then, so they're doing basically the orbiter approach, if you will. They basically bodyguarded their Hog Rider really well. That seems to be the only thing that's getting through at all. I could play more basically defensive with my tower, but honestly, I'd rather get more units on the field so I can basically push on to their side. I feel that's like one of the bigger strengths of this deck, is that I can actually afford to put a whole bunch of units into play. And yeah, I totally get that Hog Riders are vicious and they're totally gonna come get me, but you know, you got enough guys on the field and that's not really the point. Okay, so poison on that's gonna at least nuke some of those barbarians. My baby dragon's in amazing position. This Tesla has to go down because, as I said, the thing that's doing damage on my side of the field is that Hog Rider. We'll probably take this relatively easily. We'll find out. A second baby dragon never hurt anybody. Except for probably my opponents, and that's okay with me. Giant skeleton once again. We're saving the freeze for the Hog Rider that'll come next, most likely. And do. Screw it, Dark Prince. Get out there, do me some damage. Oh look, you're on the tower. Enjoy that. Speaking of getting on the tower, that's what I should do. There goes basically all of my units, but I got poison down as an attempt to actually get this taken care of. More units, more units, more units. We only got 15 seconds left. This feels like it's going to go to a tie. Let's try really hard not to tie. Even if we have to get a little bit risky. There it is! And last second as usual. As I said, that's kind of like the way this deck plays. It's risky, it's rewarding, and it's fun. I think it's almost... I would easily say it's probably a foolish deck. And that I don't mind playing like a fool, because I'm playing like I'm having fun, because I am having fun. Let's see here. Yeah, 1 HP is not where I want to end my games. From the last one, and this one, I mean, it was the same thing. It's like, hey, I'm basically wagering how many hits my towers can take to be able to take down their tower with my strategy. Sometimes you gamble well, and sometimes you don't. You can totally split push, you can totally stick to one lane. You just have to, you know, feel out what you think is going to be the better strategy in the short game. Against people who play Hog Rider, you probably shouldn't split push, because the Hog Rider, if you give it enough time, usually comes through. You have to be really careful about basically leaving your tower open. Hog Rider does not like to go into a lot of nasty fire. So, you know, they can split push, but that also means that they then have to basically take either one of your towers hard. Hog Rider, unless he's like level 7, probably not going to kill your tower by himself without at least freeze. And that's 8 elixir. So, once again, you see somebody hog riding, you probably stick to one lane, you probably punish their hog rider, and you try to get as many units down as you can to just basically break up everything that they got going for them. I picked fighters. Like, that's basically what I feel like is most of my deck at this point. Giant Skeleton is not truthfully a fighter. He's more of a tank that happens to blow up, so he's kind of a jerk. But, you know, Spear Goblins, they're here to chuck spears. You know, my flyer is, he's a baby dragon. He literally is there for fighting. He does the AoE. He just sits there and just rains death on people. And I mean, Dark Plint basically does the same thing, but he's on land and he gets his charge. So when I'm fighting stuff like, as I said, Hog Rider, oh my god, I don't have freeze. I don't have my tower, or I don't have my Tesla. What do? You beat him up. I mean, honestly, that's what you do, is you kill him. And it's not always easy, but it is fun. And I imagine we're going to see more hog riding post-patch. So, you know, that's only advice I can give you on that. I know what I don't like fighting against. And, you know, sometimes I have to send my hog rider in there against a whole bunch of nasty stuff. And it's just what it is. Sometimes it's the spear goblins who do most of my tower damage. Sometimes it's sometimes it's my hog rider. And honestly, sometimes it's just that there's like two baby dragons and a dark prince on their side of the field. And they're going nowhere. You throw any little garbage character at them and they will destroy it instantly. I really like those characters for that reason. Because, you know, you throw one or two elixir counter and I go, poof, it's dead. Thanks for the elixir, guy. Moving on that away towards your tower. So, questions I got is, do you stream daily? I am absolutely not going to claim that I stream daily at this point. I took like a week off. But I try to do an average of a stream a day if I am not taking any breaks and time off. But that also might mean that I do 2 streams in one day or something like that. And so I will not guarantee that I stream every day. And then you suck, you're so bad. Excellent. Fantastic. You are totally watching me suck and be so bad. I apologize for how terrible I am. Oh my god, donate, donate, donate. Give me them XPs. Anyway, we'll get back to the action. Over 2,300. That's not a bad place to be. We should try to get a little bit higher, see what we can get out of this. At least get the crown chest. Decent opening hand. Better opening hand right now. Please go down faster. There we go. So, they're throwing a bunch of junk at us, and, oh, man, if those spear goblins had not been blown up, that would be a super gross opening charge. But they did. We're going to be slightly cautious, and by that I mean poisoning, because I like poisoning. Worked out pretty well. We got some damage on their tower. It's looking okay. Goblin barrels will steer goblin barrels. I mean, they get them on you fast enough, and once again, I don't have arrows. I don't have the ability to go, oh, look at my amazing timing. I wiped out your barrel. So, you know, we gotta work with what we got. And then we're going to throw Tesla because they're not putting any moves down. That giant's going to take forever to get here. That Tesla's going to be half dead by the time it gets here. We're going to need real support for it. I could hog ride right now, but let's face it, that's absolutely going to not work. Against that, I think we're going to throw basically Dark Prince off to the flank. We are going to throw Spear Goblins for extra oomph. That barrel is gonna just devastate me. So unfortunately, I'm freezing it. It's like the worst thing I want to do right now, but it's gonna be worth it because this is gonna stop the hemorrhage right there. They would have taken massive damage if I had not done that. Boop. Waiting for some elixir to come back up. They throw mostly small guys, right? I'm gonna be in trouble because that means that basically I usually forward push. And you know, their barrel in the back, it's gonna suck, honestly. Oh, here it comes again, by the way. Nah, they're just gonna... anyway. Let's move on to getting some towers. We only have 54 seconds left. Are we gonna win this game? No, we're not gonna win this game. Getting a tower at least gives it something for the day. We got a crown tower out. They're a cool guy. They use a rocket on my hog rider. I guess that is a way that you could fight against hog rider. Baby dragon's gonna go down. All of my stuff's gonna go in the back. As you can see, they devastated me. It's because I didn't play smart against their minion horde, which, once again, no arrows, so I gotta play smart, and I didn't. This is definitely the punishment. Okay, so we're gonna get on their side of the field. We'll see what the hog rider can do. I'm assuming that he's gonna get bodyguarded a little bit. The answer is not enough. Because there's no way that I'm getting that in the amount of time we got left. It's unfortunate, is what it is. At least, I mean, hey, anybody see a mortar there? Heck no, we didn't. Oh my god, throw those fierce goblins, throw them. Anyway, so, took a loss. We actually fought somebody who played units. Crazy talk. I don't think I saw them play a defensive unit. I'm going to be very curious and see if they have any. No, they have arrows and rocket. So that's definitely one way to play the game, and they get big kudos for doing that. I got no problem losing to that. I was pretty sure they didn't have any defensive unit. If so, oh my goodness. Okay, so... yeah, oh yeah, absolutely. I'm totally friendly battle. So live commentary is the best... thank you very much for joining the clan. There's nothing more fun than somebody who will trash talk for me. Honestly, like, anyway, I appreciate it. So let's get this going. We'll push out what hopefully everybody knows how to counter by now. I would hope they would know how to counter this. But then again, True just joined recently. We'll see. He might get some of this down. We'll see. The bomb's not gonna make it. I got a Dark Prince going in. The bomb doesn't really do anything for me, like damage-wise. Spear Goblin, nah, not so effective. We're definitely gonna throw down a Tesla for the Musketeer. At this point, I'm more than willing to acknowledge that I'm probably pretty bad at countering Musketeers. I think I don't take them seriously enough, and that's stupid of me. But eh. It's what I can do. So, roadblock time. Bomb's not gonna get... No. Oh, man, it's honestly gonna get everything. That's amazing. So, let's get out there. We'll get some tower damage going. Valkyrie's a solid card. However, I personally think Hog Rider is the best. Because, you know, I play it constantly. We'll throw down poison, slow them down a bunch. And then, as soon as they get on the tower, ta-da, spear goblins. Sneaky, sneaky spear goblins. Anyway, throwing them spears. There will eventually be a Photoshop tribute to my spear goblins. They will have gigantic biceps and gigantic shoulders. With little teeny spears that they throw. Because if you hadn't noticed, near the end of the spear's throwing duration, they actually shrink, which is, I don't know, I think it's personally funny. I've got a pretty weird sense of humor. But, you know, it's just as it is. Valkyrie going off the left-hand side, that could be the start of a split push, we'll see. I feel like my goblins at this point might not die. And then... poison! And then Tesla. And then Dark Prince. And then I will absolutely hog ride that. So we're going to call that my tower now. And then we're going to call this Freeze. Nothing better than being a jerk with Freeze. And then, so he very tactically may get all of that tower, like right now, just so we're clear. We'll see if I can fight it off. Nope, I got it. Yeah. Anyway. I personally really like, as I said, this deck. It usually comes down to the last minute or so. It's got a lifespan that's specifically built around how long you actually fight for. So if it's like, oh, but you would lose in overtime, I'm like, yes, but this game is almost primarily built on not going into, like, super long overtime. By overtime, I'm talking about the 3 minutes of overtime you have with friendly matches and tournament. And then, did you already throw down friendly for that match? Nope. Anyway, this one's for King. I will use the caps locks. There it goes. King, you are totally going to play a Mortar. I'm calling it right now. I don't know what your deck was. I don't do that. But if you play Mortar, I swears, you're just trying to help me out. Oh, no, no Mortar. Playing Golem, huh? So this stinks because Golem is definitely a deck. Any Golem is difficult for me to deal with because I'm pretty sure it's difficult for everybody to deal with. Golems are jerks. I got no problem admitting that. So there's this. We need a good charge off of that. Bomb does nothing. Good job. And then Baby Dragon's going to sit here. He's going to chill. He's not going to do, you know, he's not going to take any damage, and that's why I like him so much. You actually have to actively work on the Baby Dragon or else, oh, that's... So, Mini Pika goes chop chop, and, like, my Hog Rider goes, I died... Mini Pika is super underrated. I'm more than willing to say that. Just look at how much damage he did right there. Two hits, 800 damage. That was super fast. Does the Pika always get there? No, absolutely not. None of the units always get there. That would be insane if you had a unit that always gets there. That's basically spells. Oh yeah? Why? We'll give you a thumbs up. Oh my god. Shocker. So the question is, how much are you going to spend to stop this on your left-hand side? Because I haven't honestly done that much on the right-hand side. Like, think about it. I've honestly not done enough to really care about that. Is this risky? Yeah, it's stupid. Is it fun? Absolutely. I mean, when are you going to find out exactly what a level 3 or a level 3 golem does to your tower if you decide to be super crazy and just go buck wild on things? I mean, at least a friendly match is great for that, right? So far, it is kicking the crap out of me, is the answer. Hey, no cry faces. There's no crying in baseball and or Clash. So we didn't make almost any dent on the left-hand side. We're going to try really hard to be a jerk to King now, just for fun. I don't think we're getting that in 22 seconds, let's just be honest. But if we can, it'll be fun. I will not go to his provocation, because, quite honestly, you know, if we get down the left tower, then we got to deal with the right. The obvious answer there was that going for the split push against the Golem and trying to distract didn't work. Golem needs to be dealt with. It's got way too much HP. So let's toss this out. We'll do some more. If you guys want friendly battles, leave them in there. If you put my name in the friendly battle, I will totally know to do them instead of continue trying to mercilessly beat other people into the ground on the ladder. Spear Goblins seems good. Baby Dragon seems good. And then Hog Rider with a freeze behind it does seem... Oh, it seems less good now. I mean, come on. So we're going to take the flak for this. That extra tower hitting my Hog Rider basically is going to spell disaster for me. That's not enough of those barbarians, quite honestly. And this poison is all I got, and it's a bad solution. I'm throwing down sacrificial goblins. Their job is to basically soak as much damage as they can instead of those towers. There should be way more damage missing from that tower than there is. And so thank you, my sacrificial goblins. I am a terrible person, and I've used you thusly. Okay. So, if they give us the time to recoup, I'm going to throw my giant skeleton from all the way in the back. Dark Prince, just deal with that. Just deal with it. Just deal with it. So, this will be worth it. We'll turn around on that. Baby Dragon's all I need to deal with this. I think it's going to get basically melted by that Inferno Tower. I don't think it'll fly outside of its range. I'm honestly watching this just to see approximately how far it goes. They see that. They throw down basically their minion horde to punish. Good for them. And I'm honestly just waiting on that Inferno Tower to die. Is it boring? Yeah, absolutely it's boring. I apologize. But we've got this filled up nicely. We're going to throw Tesla out to not distract, apparently. So I was slow on that, so that makes it my fault. Dark Prince hopefully will get in front of that, because my goblins do real damage. Poison will go down for death-dealing capabilities. And Baby Dragon... I think you're honestly wasted at this point, and that's unfortunate. I would love to get more on that tower. Bomb's going to go off with no real effect. And Baby Dragon's going to do a good job of getting over there. Ooh, Hog Rider, maybe? No, Hog Rider's going to get murdered by that. Enjoy a second Tesla. If you want to play, you know, defense game, totally cool. Let's go for it. We'll throw Dark Prince behind it. At least we'll probably get two. Get over to their Inferno Tower. Of course not. They're going to throw Barbarians, some of my least favorite guys out there. Grats. Dark Prince, keep being the champ that you are. Baby Dragon, save my butt. Tesla, keep me from that heathen Hog Rider. Heathen, 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 etc. It's just a silly word. I don't know why I like it so much. We're going to absolutely throw some poison on this just as soon as it comes up. If you guys hadn't noticed, poison is a big deal for me because it augments my push strategy pretty well. It makes it so that people who want to chase my Hog Rider, they can go ahead and do that. And I will sit here and go, ha 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 ha. Enjoy that poison. We've got to stop at least the barbarians from getting on the tower. And then, oh look, we've got, you know, some actual push going for it. Another poison will deal with the damage for this. We want to put it in front of the tower so that if they throw any more things out, it'll get basically stuck and slowed down. We got 7 seconds of overtime. I think that's enough time. Hopefully I won't feel bad. Nope, there it is. Last second. Clinch, 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 clinch. That's all I do. I hope it's good for everybody watching. And as I said, I built this deck and it seems to only operate to basically take victories against fair play in the last 10-15 seconds of fights. So I'm literally telling you that I will be drawing out every match as long as humanly possible. Let's see what we got. Boop, 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 boop. Oh yeah, we got Frozen in here too. Fallen Archer goes, I joined your clan today and I only have 27 donations. If I keep that up, we'll be kicked, or is that good? No, if you donate, that's what keeps you in the clan. We have no reason to kick people out. I doubt we need to make this clan competitive. Supercell's never given us any real motivation to be like, OMG, I need the number one ranked clan in the game. I'm like, no, I want nice people that will actually have fun and do stuff with each other. That's what I want. I don't care if, here, we'll do this for fun. We'll go right over here where the people who care about their opinion and being like fancy are. So, oh my god, they have like double our trophies. Oh my god, like that makes them so cooler than us. Or does it mean that we're still having just as much fun as them? I don't know. As I said, if these numbers mattered, then maybe I would care. But for right now, I'm having a lot of fun with my clan. You donate, that means you're active. That means you don't want to get kicked. That's it. There's no, like, I put 1,000 requirement for to get in. That's not hard. That puts you somewhere around the 4 and 5 arena, depending on where you've gotten to or if you've had some difficulties. And quite honestly, that's not that hard to get to. So, you know, it's good. Aero only, says King. Let's go. Oh, very nice. King, as usual, makes decks specifically for me. Well, I know what I'm doing there. This is the one exception of my deck. If you throw out an elixir pump immediately, I will happily oblige you in wrecking your junk up. Good placement on the barbarians. We're doing friendly match, so my brain does not work. So unfortunately, my Dark Prince doesn't do nearly the damage that he does when he's level 4. Barbarians 9 and above, usually he can't take out single-handedly, but he could have probably taken those guys out by himself if you're a jerk. Let's do this. Ho-ho! Yeah, so King, as usual, obliges me. I go, we don't have to worry about mortars much longer. Let's see how many we got today, and he plays a mortar like a jerk. Good for you, sir. I am very impressed with you right now. So we'll throw Spear Goblins behind it. Baby Dragon was totally helping there. That's honestly the only reason why that went down that way. we will definitely do thumbs up. Boop, boop, boop. So we'll toss a Hog Rider out. There it is. That's what I wanted to see. Oh my god, poison. 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 Yeah, so see how quick that first mortar got to me? I preemptively had a Hog Rider down, and it still got to me. Man, I wonder why they are changing things. Mystery. Anyway. I'm gonna give it my all. This'll be fun. Oh, I see how this is. Somebody is mirroring, apparently. At least I think he's mirroring. That came out way too quick. Regardless of using one skeleton, or one elixir skeletons, that was way too quick. Hog Rider, that is a cannon, that is not a mortar. You are a jerk to me. Anyway, bomb's gonna go off, sayonara. Baby dragon, fight, fight, fight. Oh my god, yeah, so he's mirroring. You're a jerk. I am very impressed with you right now. We're gonna throw this Tesla out here for extra anti-jerk tactics. And then I'm gonna throw poison, because those are my jerk tactics. Poison, 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 poison. Hog Rider! Oh my god, is it another mortar? Did you mirror it again? freeze tactics, FT dubs. Yeah, I totally acknowledge that Hog Rider and freeze, freeze and anything, honestly, is a good combo. And some people are asking for that to be nerfed next. You know, that's a thing you can absolutely ask for. We'll see how basically the game turns out after we get done with this 5-3 patch. And yeah, we'll have fun. Dream Chaser is right here. Or Dream Crusher. Ooh. Very different. The difference between a U and an A can make right there. This is where he beats me mercilessly. And I go, no, my feels. My dreams were crushed. That would be kind of amazing, actually. Boop. We'll start this out the fun way. So, we're gonna deal with that way. Good job. That is terrifying. That is just terrifying. I don't know how to say it any other way than that. Giant Skeleton's not getting off that Tesla in time. It's unfortunate. Because Dream Crusher hasn't been in my my clan very long. So the right side combo that just got thrown, that's pretty common for me. The Giant Skeleton into basically the Dark Prince, I will throw that all day every day if I can. And then... Ooh, Rage! Oh my god, Rage is hot. Anyway, I've been mercilessly crushed by people who played Rage. I'm sorry, that requires so much higher level of skill than so many cards. I would love to play with Rage, and I fully acknowledge that I just don't have it within me to be able to play that well. And, you know, you could be like, oh my god, Aero, you suck. But I'm like, I know well enough not to set myself up for failure. Oh, Poison totally does attack Tesla. I swear it didn't the other day, and I am glad I checked that out, because, you know, Tesla's really good for sticking under the sand like a little mole. He's a little underminer king. Oh my god. But now I don't have poison! But yeah, fight time, basically. Thank goodness. Whew. And then we're going to toss some support action in there. Bomb's going to blow up. Dark Prince is going to basically push him into place. My Tesla is going to attack his Tesla. And then Hog Rider is absolutely going to go out. And this is an interesting thing, by the way. I did not even know Rage worked on buildings until after I stopped trying to use it. Which obviously shows I'm not a very good tester. I'm okay with that. Everybody's got their pluses and minuses. Oh yeah, poison, poison, poison. All day, day. So, you know, that was interesting information for me. As I said, personally, I can't use Rage. It's probably a deck preference choice. But quite honestly, getting, like, running up on the opponent's tower and getting more attacks in sounds really great. I just don't like what I would have to give up for it. Maybe poison won't be required after, the mortars stop being so obnoxious, but for right now, I use them against mortars, I use them against spawners, I use them against basically unit spammers. If it's really bad and they've got like a real tank in front of it, poison saves my butt. Oh my god, I need more Hog Rider, I agree. And a free chest. Woo! And then Trey Johnson wants a shout-out. Shout-out for you. Also, Hog Rider! Which arena does the witch come in? And that's the... It comes in the first one. Right there. Boop. Training camp. And Dark Prince is Arena 7. Anyway, yes. So anyway, yeah, that's hopefully your information. It's useful. Dark Prince is great, by the way. I did not anticipate that I was going to like him as much as that I do. But I do. You did great. And I'm not joking about that. Even with like the rules as they are to basically limit how high I can go, I've still got to have a card advantage on you. And anybody tells you that card advantage doesn't matter, it's all about skill, yeah, sure it is. I'm totally okay with that explanation, but here's the fun part. If you mismatch what you've got and you're lower, like you're already at a disadvantage, and then your deck doesn't mesh well against their deck, yeah, I mean, sure, it doesn't matter, it's all skill. No, there's enough luck in this game that I enjoy it. I am... definitely a person who enjoys the gambling and the gambling sense. Video game gambling is great for me because I don't go home poor. So, you know, this for me is a little bit gambling and I like it. Anyway. Rant off, more arena, murder. Now King's just being silly. I totally did just get skeletons. Just add that to my deck. Mm-mm. So, if they're not going to go, I'm going to go. It's a big investment, don't get me wrong. I'm not like, oh my god, I love going first. I hate going first. But, I'm not going to sit there and wait. They use Jolt. Good for them. They'll get some damage. Dark Prince needs to go out sooner than later. If nothing else, they basically fouled up my right-hand side. The Dark Prince really does need to get out there to basically push him forward. Bomb's going to go off. This is going to be good for basically that. But, you know, Goblins hopefully is not what I was aiming to get killed out of basically a giant skeleton. It's kind of going for their tower. And their Hog Rider is obviously coming if on the left-hand side. I'm really tempted to switch over to the left-hand side just so that my units can block their Hog Rider. This is going to get really dangerous for me. Basically, I'm giving up the right-hand side. We're not going to give up our Tesla yet. And this time we're going to wait on to see what they want to play. Because, you know, I went first and they basically got into play defense against me the entire time. And, you know, it gets a little bit boring. Wow, this person's seriously not going to play anything, huh? Congratulations. I'll play my baby dragon. So, their Joel placement there was literally to get another big hit on my Dark Prince. Smart, honestly. If their Hog Rider doesn't come next, I'm not going to believe it. Hog Rider, Spear Goblins, Giant Skeleton. Sorry. I've noticed more and more as I play, it's much easier to read people to remember what their decks are quickly, to like get out there and try to really push your advantage. Holding on to your Tesla is, I can only say it is, like, it's smart stuff. You want to be able to remember when to basically counter Hog Rider, counter balloons, counter things that really wreck up your towers. Because, I mean, look at this guy. Without being opposed, he did bunches of damage to my tower. And now we're opposing him. Don't get me wrong, he's totally going to go for basically late game tactics. He can easily spell down my stuff because he's got both Fireball and Jolt. It's not the perfect combination for him, but believe you me, that's what he's going to do. If he's smart. Because, I mean, he's basically two rotations away from beating me right now. Like, no questions. We can't sit around for just that reason alone. It's unfortunate. The likelihood of their Hog Rider getting through with me being this aggressive is high. But that's just what we gotta do, honestly. Oh, there it is. Oh my god. Anyway. Good game. Here's a fireball. Oh my god, I've never seen that before. Anyway. So as I said, you get better at certain aspects of the game, doesn't mean you're gonna beat everybody. It's great that I can figure out approximately when their Hog Rider's probably gonna come out. It's still random. It's not like I can predict exactly what cards are in his deck. Your deck doesn't cycle linearly. It has the possibility of scooting cards up and scooting cards back, so it might take too long to get the cards that you want for certain strategies. Gambling once again. But I love it, you know. It gives you a general idea of what's going on. And then, been figuring out how to use Royal Giants. Haven't figured it out. Oh my god. So Akak's trying to figure out Royal Giants in preparation to basically our patch apocalypse. So the worst I've ever seen it is you throw, like, you throw a giant, a Royal Giant with a wizard behind him. The basic idea being that anything tries to oppose the Royal Giant, because obviously you have to kill him, other than a structure... the Royal Giant ignores, and then the wizard goes, Fireball, Fireball, Fireball. And, you know, he's super cool and stuff. So that would be my impression on how to start playing him. I'm sure you'll figure out way better strategies if you actually took the time to play him, as opposed to what I've just been wrecked with occasionally, because I absolutely got wrecked by that. I remembered it very hard. I basically played enough Elixir in the right-hand lane that they just threw that down in the left lane. In my left lane, it was over fast, is the only way I'm going to tell you it. It was really impressive, honestly. And then, so, next question is, what's the number one feature you wanted to add to clans, or to Clash? I think I just touched on it earlier. We've got, like, under 20,000 clan trophies you know, the super cool clans that are at the top of the ranking, and they are on, like, the Clash TV. They are the cool guys. They shoot the guns and stuff. I like playing with all the people that are in my clan. I wish there were some sort of clan-to-clan, like, action that could go on. That was sort of the core tenet that got so many people excited in Clash Royale, or in Clash of Clans. And if it got added to this game, and I'm not saying a direct one-to-one, I'm saying something. Some sort of, like, inter-clan stuff. It would not stop me from keeping people who are growing. I would not be like, OMG, you're not at the top of the leaderboard. Kick my clan. I'm not about that. I am about being competitive and having fun and basically fostering an environment where people can have fun. If people were intentionally being, like, non-participant, that's a different situation altogether. But people who are here and they're trying, they're going nowhere. It makes no sense to be mean to people who are legitimately being nice. Doesn't. Anyway. Maybe use Barbs ahead as a tank or a Dark Prince. Yeah, totally. Barbs I would pick over the Dark Prince because the Dark Prince will run off and hit the tower. But while that seems like it would be a great idea, if you're focusing on making sure that basically the giant is really getting in his power time, like, because he hits hard. So long as it's truthfully worth making sure that you safeguard him, much like a mortar, who would have thought? But hey, a mortar that has to walk around instead of just hit you from your side of the base. Shocker. Then it really comes down to whether or not defense is truly more important for his offense than the rest of your team's offense. We'll find out. I'm sure if you have a really high-leveled Royal Giant, which I'm sure people in my clan have because they've complained mercilessly about hating to get Royal Giants in their chests. So we'll see. My clan is going to just be full of a whole bunch of crazy Royal Giant players. It's going to be great. but yeah, clan wars. And I don't need it to be psychotically elitist. I would like it just to be fun. And here's the big thing. Okay, so I always believe in content that if you are required, or basically it's extra, you have to do organization, there has to be rewards for it. I'm not saying that, like, that there have to be such amazing rewards that, like, you'd be stupid not to be trying to, like, push the top of the leaderboards, but I'm just saying, you tell me, oh my god, you should go PvP all day long, that's the end game of our game, mind you, that's the end game of this game, and it's successful and fantastic because they actually give me real opponents every time, and not people who are just sort of AFK farming it, but real rewards that actually have a purpose, or have no purpose whatsoever, they're just glitz and glamour and fun stuff, that's also perfectly acceptable, I will, you know, grind a game 2,000 hours for a single hat. Don't talk about it. Ragnarok Online is amazing. Anyway, but, you know, that's basically my big thing. If we could get a little bit more interaction between clans, that would be a really interesting turn. But they need to do it correctly, and I have confidence in their ability to do that. So far, they've made really good games. This game is really good. If they take the time and implement intelligent things slowly, that would be better than them basically pushing out some half-baked garbage idea that has obvious flaws. I'm sorry, it's the internet. We're gamers. We complain. We're very vocal and obnoxious. Forums are amazing, like, places to watch toxicity rise at, like, the most alarming rate ever. Other than, never mind, I'm not going to get political. Yeah. So long as things are done well, that is what I ask. We're looking for more interaction. I stream this game because I'm looking for more interaction. That's hopefully why everybody's, you know, watching. Maybe you're at your work, you don't want to play yourself, you just want to hang out. Totally cool with that. I don't always want to play video games, is the fun part. That didn't happen until much later, though. I'm more than willing to admit that I'm a gigantic, gigantic nerd, and that I love playing video games because escapism is great. Look at that little bomb guy. He hits so hard and doesn't get enough credit. I would love to fit him back into my deck, but there's no way. Oh god. Okay, so, I've got two spells in my deck, right? So, let's do this properly. So, there's freeze, and there's poison. And there's Dark Prince. Because, no, seriously, two Musketeers. It's still super gross. We just crushed their rage. That was four Elixir that, if we had played that earlier, would not have been wasted. We're doing just fine right now. If we had not, they would have come out ahead massively, one way or another. I don't have poison. I'm not going to be able to do anything with that. If they are playing that, I really do need to actually put forth a real push. If we play him in the back and then play the baby dragon in the front, what we're going to get is basically a scenario where we can knock down their tower without having to mess with the giant skeleton. We do know that they have three musketeers, but they shouldn't have it for enough time that we might actually get a lot of damage in on this. Speak of the devil, poison is going to do a great job here. We don't have enough for freeze. We don't need it. They're just sitting in the poison. That's good enough. Okay, so this is an angry giant. Angry giant play. They didn't play smart. They played angry. I'm okay with that. Sometimes I play angry. Dark Prince is basically going to tank for the back of this. Clean out as much as possible. We now have a two-pronged approach. Maybe we only have a one-pronged approach. We'll find out. 26 seconds left. I would not have gone that way, little baby dragon. Okay, so we kind of got to do this in stages. They're all in basically my poison. Freeze is an appropriate thing to do right there. Now we throw out the Tesla because the giant is still there. But don't lie to yourself. They probably have enough spear goblins and regular goblins that they can wreck me up if they get a good enough tank. And, you know, we're doing great. I don't have a lot of exposure against three musketeers. Some people play them in upper arenas, and quite honestly, they're so darn expensive. You don't see them very often. They're very difficult to play. However, I've seen three musketeer rage combo just destroy me. All they have to do is wait for you to throw enough elixir in one lane, pick the other lane, throw them down in rage, and it is done fast. So I'm not trying to be like, oh my god, you should totally play that. I'm just like, I've seen that and it has hurt, and I felt like an idiot. Because, you know, like, I literally was sitting there going, I don't have anything to stop them at all. Because I just threw all of my elixir the other way. It was merciless. It was amazing. I want to see that instead of mortars. Bang. But yeah, let's keep going with this. What time is it? Apologies about the neck spasminess that I have going on. When my back gets a little bit crazy, the only thing I can do is go and bobblehead for you guys. So, what I had to throw down on the left-hand side was basically a bunch of garbage. It was literally just to make it so the prince couldn't get the charge. My Dark Prince is not even doing the same damage that their one prince did while opposed. Should give you an idea of what the difference is between a Dark Prince and a regular prince. This is problematic for me as well. We're going to have to throw poison. And then behind, I'm going to throw a Dark Prince. Once again, look at that beautiful, beautiful action. He just knocked everybody out. So proud of him. I don't have enough spell power to back up my Hog Rider. That's a complete sacrifice. I'm terrible at life. Somebody stop making me play this game. Jokes. I play this game because it's fun. Baby Dragon's not going to do enough. They're going to get some hits. But honestly, all their damage is already on the left-hand side. I put too much resources on the right-hand side, and they can just do whatever they want on the left-hand side. So we'll avoid doing that for now. Okay, so Giant Skeleton is really great for very specific things, and he goes great in front of a prince, is all I'm going to tell you. We want a Tesla right... No, we definitely don't want a Tesla there. That's bad. And then, so barbarians are going to come out on those guys instead of my hog rider. I'll take it. Are we going to lose that tower? If we didn't throw anything else, absolutely. Dark Prince with a Tesla will be plenty. I'm pretty sure they just misclicked that pretty hard. Same offense as before. You can see the tower is getting on him too. He's going nowhere. We are going to be a little bit of... No, we're just going to have to let that die. It's very unfortunate, but it's not worth basically losing the ability to defend the left-hand side, which they're totally going to come for once again. I mean, that's just what they're going to do. Baby Dragon comes from, like, the entire right-hand side of the field. I can't predict why he would do that. But apparently he's just got greater vision than everybody else because he's so high up. That's still shocking to me that he participated in that fight at all. Once again, Hog Rider just getting crushed. Like, this guy has stopped my Hog Ride really good, really well, very well. Anyway, but once again, last second, if I give them a little bit more time, what was going to happen there? That minion horde and those goblins are going to wreck me up. There is always some last-ditch effort that you will put in with your elixir when you know for a fact there won't be any more fight after you play certain cards, even if they're like it's a bad idea to play them aggressively, like fireballs or rockets at the very end of matches. There won't be the rest of the match, so that's where you can basically start getting away with playing those heavier, more risky maneuvers to try to finish something out. And quite honestly, if I had managed to push that back, it's very possible I would have been able to basically go into their side of the base and just take as much of that left tower as I want. That should be part of your mindset when you're getting down to the last couple of seconds. As I said, this deck goes to basically, it goes down to the wire an awful lot. And that's one of the things that I've picked up personally from it, is that it's not necessarily about the averages and, like, my elixir cost is 4.0. People have told me that's too high. I just don't care. It seems manageable. Maybe this is what's keeping me out of Legendary Arena. Okay, great. Or I could just play better. You know, and we'll find out whether or not any of that's true in the future. But the whole point is that boiling this down to math will not work. Why did the baby dragon literally pull from all the way on the right-hand side over to the left-hand side? Unit interaction in this game is... it might become more uniform in this next patch, because that's what they tried to do with basically their strike durations. But the whole point is that when you throw basically all the pieces down and you let the computer determine how their AI goes, as I said, gambling, it can turn out differently than you think it will. And that really makes this game exciting and fun. But the point that I was making there is that if you play this game just sitting there like a strategist and a robot, you know, you at least take from it that at the end, when there is no more after the fact, that you have a tremendous opportunity to throw all of your elixir in a way that you shouldn't do normally, because it'll get you countered super hard. So, you know, hopefully that helps. Let's see what else we got here. Heck, I'm not at 2400 yet, right? We're somewhere close to the hour range. I used to have a policy where I'd go 45 minutes to an hour. That doesn't seem to slow me down as much as it used to, so that's great. We'll keep going for a little bit, maybe like another 15 or 20 minutes, something like that. And I'll definitely do another stream tomorrow. It's the weekend. I got nothing better to do. I'm lazy. I love being antisocial. Oh my god, look at freaking Mortar. We won the game. How many Mortars will you see today? And the answer was some of them. I knew there had to be some of them. So, Baby Dragon, and then Hog Rider after it. Nah, actually, that's too much elixir. I'm being reckless and crazy. Pressuring a Mortar player is a good way to basically throw them off their game. So that's part of what I'm doing here. But I've also, quite honestly, played too much elixir. That's why they're able to get onto my tower without actually using their mortar. If they don't play their mortar next to my butt, you know, like, it's a preemptive Tesla. Is it going to slow them down to the point where they won't use it? No, they'll just wait out my Tesla. No, we'll just hog ride. If they want to wait around, that's totally cool. That'll be enough for to get freeze out. Mortar's just sitting there. That's the best part about this. I don't think the mortar can attack from that position. That's great for me. Baby dragon's gonna get shot down. It sucks, but it's just what it is. Don't get me wrong. This is misplay. So Hog Rider's gonna go completely unattested. The spear goblins would have easily finished him off. Not the case. Okay, so we have our combo. Is it risky? Absolutely. I don't think I can hold on to that tower. They have a mortar. It'll go down. I'm going with basically strategic action. We'll call it strategic action. As though it's not just me being reckless and putting down all the numbers. Okay. So, thing number two that's going to have to go out is we're going to need some more support. How about I freeze all of this? And I say that because, no, seriously, how about I freeze all of this? The mortar's going to go down. Giant's gonna get blown up. It's gonna suck. Let's see what we can get. We got 30 seconds. I'm totally good with it. Let's make this an actual match. As I said, today is the swan song of Mortar. I want to see their finishing cry. I want to see the people who are desperate to put priority of trophies over fun and actually playing their game. And I want to see what they actually got today. Because let's face it, they've been getting away with basically cheap victories for, you know, a month or so at this point. And so this makes me feel good. Because I'm an evil, evil person. Oh my god, more stuff. You should totally get more stuff. And freeze. Oh my god, get more damage. So it looks like I'm not going to take it to him. It sucks. They did manage to get on my side of the field. But whatever. We didn't lose to a mortar. Who would have thought? A mortar that draws. They must be having oodles of fun over there. Akak, as usual, is my anti-mortar support group. When I need to cry, I go to Akak. I'm like, Akak, they were mean to me. They threw rocks. He's like, it's okay. They'll probably be, I don't know, it'll be burst into flames, you know, like thrown down a cliff and then eaten by a wild animal. It's usually what he tells me to comfort me. And it does. I like being comforted in such a way. So we're going to throw a bunch of garbage at them. And the most aggressive Tesla I will get. I feel better about doing it now. We'll see what shenanigans they have coming for me. Oh my god. Poison is maybe will take care of this. Nah. I wanted it too much. It sucks. He's going to get at least a couple of hits. Fireball, good for you. As you can see, he got hit by a fireball, so he got knocked back. This is one of the patch notes. They had basically that Valkyries and Mini Pekka were not getting knocked back, and they're bringing order to the chaos that is Clash Royale with their uniformity. It doesn't bother me excessively, the lack of knockback on those two units, but it does make sense that it's not uniform, and it might make people a little bit angry when they're trying to play for, like, tournament and stuff like that. So I totally get it. We're putting a whole bunch of pressure on the left-hand side. They threw an elixir pump. We're saying, hey, I'm coming right at you, buddy. What you gonna do about it? Giant Skeleton's doing an excellent job of tanking. We don't need the freeze. We don't need the poison. Do I want the poison? No, I don't want the poison. I want the hog ride. Hard decision there, quite honestly, for me. Who would have thought he decided that he wanted to knock out basically that giant skeleton getting all the way to his doorstep? Not a stupid decision. But once again, Fireball, it's great for knocking stuff back and dealing damage, but my poison literally does the same amount of damage and slows people down. Poison got buffed a little bit last patch, and quite honestly, like, I wasn't against the idea of trying to use it to begin with, but I was like, oh shit, that looks great. We're going to throw this here. Hopefully it will blow up on their dragon as well. We need a replacement substitute, if you will. Dark Prince, you are the best. Oh my god, fight through it, fight through it! And then second Tesla. Poison on top of it. And Spear Goblins. That was too quick. I thought the HP that he had was his shield. And so I thought that Dark Prince was going to live a lot longer than he did. I should have thrown the giant skeleton a second later. The blow-up's going to keep the riffraff, if you will, off of my side of the board. But what it would have done is made it so that the tower was hitting their P.E.K.K.A. the entire time. If I had let him get just a little bit further onto my side, I got a little bit antsy. And short, apparently, because my webcam moved a little bit. Oh my god. I am not going to tell you what Akak's comment is for trying to make me feel better about mortar players, but it is amazing, and I will leave it at that. We're not 2400 yet. I want that chest, honestly. I was trying to go for that second tower because I wanted to get it sooner. Oh my god, he's so angrar. Look at him. He's like, arrow. Oh, hello. How are you doing today? I'm pretty sure you guys have seen me do this at least once or twice before. I hope you realize what is coming. I am hoping it will be glorious. Poison will be good enough. Oh man, level 1 Dark Prince is going to get shredded by poison. Okay, so let's keep this up. They, as I said, they have the long game advantage. Unfortunately, we overplayed, and garbage is coming my way. Baby Dragon is going to take the brunt of this. He's not going to live long. We want the tower to stay healthy. We're okay with that. And so, since we didn't manage to get any anything off of their elixir pumps, they've been getting basically extra elixir this entire time. They're at least ahead of me as far as one. They crushed my Hog Rider, which means they're actually doing really well. And now they're doing better than really well. Hopefully my giant skeleton will walk slow enough that I didn't waste any elixir there, but also that I'm not... Oh my god, they're this guy. I haven't seen this very often. It's unpleasant. There's no other way to say it other than that it is unpleasant. We're going to throw the Spear Goblins on this side. They're going to attack basically both of them. We're trying really hard to keep them up because they do significant damage. Poison's going to have to go down on the left-hand side. Honestly, that P.E.K.K.A. is going to wreck my garbage. Giant Skeleton is not Baby Dragon. He did not come over. He did not assist. He is not as good. At this point, we have to realize that we need to get on their side of the field. P.E.K.K.A. will not be stopped. Unstoppable P.E.K.K.A. What we really are trying to do is cycle for poison about as fast as we can. Hog Rider took out most of it for us. It's still going to be a bad situation. We're still not doing well because we didn't get that tower yet. And we're not going to without basically some serious, like, divergent play from what we've seen thus far. Poison will go out. And quite honestly, I'm doing this because I want him to last as long as humanly possible so Hog Rider can get up there and be a jerk. Freeze, dear God, please make it. Oh my God, that explosion was satisfying. But hey, are we gonna fight off this garbage too? I have literally no idea how I'm going to take care of this. This is big, nasty, and terrible. This is not the fight I wanted. Poison may save my butt. Oh my god. Get in there, giant skeleton. Be my hero. Be my hero. Oh my god. Okay. That is absolutely not where I wanted that to go. We're going to call a misplay and that I'm an idiot. Giant Skeleton is not in my hand, which is really unfortunate because I could use him. Yeah, no, this is very unpleasant. Tessa's the only thing I can do to stop that. I am on my heels, if you guys hadn't noticed. This means all I'm doing is reacting at this point. It's bad. I'm basically guaranteed to be taking as much damage and not picking my battles as much as humanly possible. Which means there's no way I can basically get back on the flip side without some sort of turnaround. If overtime lasted longer, this might have been a very interesting match, but as I said, as soon as they started throwing big units on my side of the field, like the Golem and the P.E.K.K.A., done. Like, there's so little you can do to unencroach them from your territory. You just don't want to give them a tower to begin with, but, I mean, you saw how quick they took the tower. Anyway. Did my best. We called it a draw. I don't want a draw, but I got a crown chest out of it. I guess that makes it okay. Or I got a crown for my crown chest. Ugh. Anyway. Let's see what we got for comments. So, Jay asked, I got into Arena 7. Is there any tip for there? So, Arena 7 is amazing because, you know, you don't have people who are basically relying on cards at that point to clip people out, in or out. It's not divergent play. It's you get to play anything. My strongest advice is that if you have a playstyle you've been playing up to this point, continue with it. If you feel like you're very off balance or that, like, basically the same sorts of strategies beat you consistently, that means there's probably a big hole in your deck. I've absolutely played with holes in my deck. They're very difficult to overcome when the other person is playing basically a very specific game and you're just like, I have nothing to counter that. A lot of my card choices have been based on whether or not I like the unit to begin with, and then whether or not it satisfies what I need in my deck to basically give myself a fighting chance. And quite honestly, for Arena 7, like, the only thing new is Dark Prince, Royal Giant, and Three Musketeers. The Dark Prince is easy enough to use. The other two are so specialized at this point, post-patch, we'll see, that you, if you want to use them, by all means, feel free to do so, but level them up, because Three Musketeers, like, three level two Musketeers, what does that do anybody? You know, like, and Royal Giant, he probably doesn't start dealing massive damage until you level him up too. But playing against them, quite honestly, that'll be up to how your deck performs against them, and they're very different cards from most of the cards you've seen up to this point. The only thing that I can really compare either of them to is a Golem, and I only make that assertion because Golems cost so much Elixir that people have to be very specific about their playstyle to incorporate them. The Three Musketeers are most certainly that kind of an item. And as I said, without experience, it's very hard for me to tell you how to counter them. You see me, I poison them and I freeze them. What if you don't have poison or freeze? Aero, what do we do then? I'm like, oh, I die. I die mercilessly to them. Three Musketeers will knock down a Dark Prince almost immediately. A Giant Skeleton can stop them, but that is 6 Elixir. To counter their 8-9 Elixir that they cost? You know, it gets dicey. You have to start making really important decisions. And quite honestly, if they don't walk onto his bomb, then you lose massively. They're very powerful. But if you haven't run into them yet, that's because they're not very easy to play. They're a specialist game. And they're not cards for common play. So play like you've been playing. Play well. And always think about what you can do to improve your game as far as positioning and timing and Elixir management, and you will get better at this game. Those are really the things that matter. Then don't build a deck that's garbage. But I would have difficulty thinking that any deck you can put together is completely garbage, but they might be really hard thematically to play. Just because the cards are pretty well balanced, honestly. Yeah, anyway. Rant over. Sorry. I'll get on those if you ask deep questions. But yeah. And the other thing is, so if you go back and look at some of my videos, you'll notice that I got stuck between basically 2000 and 2200. I ping-ponged for a long time there. I will tell you straight out, that's when I had a level 5 hog rider. I hit level 6 hog rider. All of a sudden, I got better. It literally came down to making sure that what deals damage for me to take down their towers. Got a little hefty upgrade so that I didn't have to worry about possibly losing in dire straits. But you should know what basically is the unit that most often pays out for you for as far as tower hits go. That should be what you upgrade first. Unless they've got like something really resoundingly great about another unit because it's like your full defense. That is easily the best advice I can give you as far as deck upgrades. Also, Hog Rider is awesome. Hog Rider! Anyway. I mean, make it so I ride in on a bear instead of a pig and maybe I'll be less interested in Hog Rider. But for right now, like, unless you throw like a moose or a bear for me to like ride in on, or like maybe some like majestic owl, I'm just not seeing me giving up Hog Rider. He's just too freaking cool. Good for him. Tesla doesn't go down fast enough. And that's misplay. Like, all I had to do is play down my Tesla a second earlier. That Hog Rider would have gotten none of that damage. Giant Skeleton needs a buddy. He needs a friend. This is definitely the friend he needed for this situation. I'm going to be running low on Elixir. He might get to the tower. We're just going to say might. That is really bad. So we're going to freeze him there. He's getting shot by both towers. That's why we waited up until that point. All of a sudden, we're looking like we actually know how to play this game. Excellent. We've got slightly more HP on our tower than their tower. That makes me the best. Or something. I don't know. I did just realize they're 2400. That doesn't make me any more or less inclined to play well. It just makes me realize that if I have to get crazy and dicey, the worst case scenario is I'll probably lose like 20 some odd elixir. And while that shouldn't necessarily be a check you make for yourself every time, it can't hurt to realize that you're basically like the situation you're actually in. It helps take the stress off for me. Is it irrelevant? Sure, why not? You should always play as though you're playing against somebody who's really going to take it from you. But, you know, sometimes it's nice to know that if you lose mercilessly to a minion horde, jerkface, I gotta get out there and do something, that at least there is the fallback that you know that you're not going to just completely lose all of your hard work for the day. Losing 40 plus trophies because somebody who is ranked much lower than you just takes you down a notch, it hurts. It hurts my feelings. I don't like it. Okay, so we're going to have to start playing smart. There it is. So I intentionally baited that because I wanted to poison at least their units a little bit when they came out. Usually people throw things like minions. I just saw that minions were definitely their forte. I had no interest in continuing that. It worked before. It's probably not going to work again. I'm totally cool with that. We'll give it a try. Spear Goblins for support. Nah, there's no way in hell we're getting anything out of this. Tesla goes down almost too slow, but quite honestly, it's looking bad. So, realistically, all I'm doing at this point is poisoning that tower. They have stalled out this game. I got nothing. They say well played, but what they actually mean is gotcha. And, you know, they're mean. My feelings. They took 29 of my trophies. Was I doing better? No. Okay, so it's around 30 when you're equal matched. Anyway, I thought I was lower than that. But that's just not me paying attention. Jason Paul goes, I've been lurking for a while. What have you been lurking about, Jason Paul? Don't get me wrong, I like my lurkers. If you just like to watch, I mean, that's cool with me. I don't imagine that I put up a YouTube channel because I don't like people watching me play video games. That would be a very contraindicated mentality for this sort of thing. Freeze. Spear Goblins. Mm. Probably could have got Hog Rider in there enough time and he would have got tanked for that, but I'm feeling better about not doing it, because this is a... It's pretty serious on the left-hand side. That could have been basically an entire tower for, you know, five-hole elixir. Prince is still dirty. Super dirty, honestly. And then I could have played that Dark Prince further back. I also clicked it a little bit to the left. I was trying to get basically the backsides of those barbarians blown off by that bomb. Backsides blown off by that barbarian with that bomb. Lots of bees. Meh. So while they throw that out, I'm going to throw this out. The likelihood of me seeing a prince is really high. I didn't think he was going to be on that side, but hey, is what it is. If I get my hits, I get my hits. Nope, we're good. Actually, we're not. That Spear Goblin, he's doing a great job of making me look foolish right now. And honestly, good for him. Like, don't get me wrong. Spear Goblins are really great. I obviously use them. And so, you know, it's not surprising. But he took off way more HP than a Spear Goblin is supposed to get. And that was just one. If there was two, that would have been complete misplay. I would have been absolutely bad. Barely got down the Tesla in time. It does not get me the added bonus of him dying extra fast to the double arrows. This was the situation I was talking about earlier. Can I get enough tank on this to actually get something out of it? And the answer is yes, I can. Oh my god, it's coming right at me. Nah, poison. I don't have anything to hard counter left side. The end. So this is what I got. I got 27 seconds left. I'm pretty okay with the prospect of being able to hold out for that long. Tesla can go down aggressively. Dark Prince can go down aggressively as well. And then... He can just be frozen, quite honestly. You've got 10 seconds. I don't have a whole bunch of buildings to throw in the way. Darn, life goes on, etc. Ooh, I did not see that. Okay, so overtime, we'll go. So the question is, how much benefit did they get from basically being able to place on my side of the towers? With their deck, honestly, I'm not sure. I'm feeling so silly right now. I didn't think he was going to be able to take that off at the very last second, but that's real bad for me. Nope. Don't got it. Oh well. Okay, well played. I literally did not see him get the hits that were required to knock down for it to be in arrows range. Number one, I get this. So yeah, don't play distracted. And actually pay attention to what you're doing, I guess, is the rules there. I just want to see it, honestly. I'm kind of surprised. It's definitely near the end, let's face it. We know that. Boop, boop, boop. Said freeze, we got it. Going at 4x speed is honestly kind of funny to me. I don't know. Like, if my voice suddenly got, like, balloony and hydrogeny, that would be amazing. So, that's approximately where it begins. We'll still go at double speed. The goblin had it to the point where I was like, okay, cool, I can take anything except of, like, below a fireball. And, you know, they didn't have fireball, so I thought it was pretty okay. This is my freeze that gets me the tower. See, that's still not it. Oh, it's a goblin! Oh, spear goblin. No, it was a okay, so the zap was what got it. Good enough. I don't honestly remember them playing zap almost that entire game. And mind you, I don't have, like, a deck that's fun to play Zap against. I don't have any squishy, easy targets. My team has high magic defense. No, I mean, they have HP. That's the same damn thing. But, anyway. Let's see. And then Frozen Goes gotta go for 20 minutes. Will it still be on? I'm definitely gonna call it here. Apologize. If you want somebody who streams, Clash Royale, absolutely sub. Like, subscribe, leave comments, whatever you want to see, realistically. We are, first and foremost, a stream that's basically about Clash Royale. I've got a clan that almost perpetually stays full at 50. And good job, Akak. And so if you want to see basically this sort of action, this is what I do. This is what I do, hopefully as often as daily. Usually I don't get to every single day, but I usually try to make it up by playing, two or three times, in a single day. We'll see though. But yeah, absolutely sub, like, subscribe, leave comments for me if you like what I'm doing. As I said many, many times before, I have a lot of fun playing this game. That's why I'm doing this. This is a lot of fun for me. And there's my clan. Support. So yeah, absolutely come back. I've got a Twitter feed that throws out when I've got videos coming out. I don't have any idea if I will ever have a schedule for my streams, but maybe I will. It's the sort of thing that I could be talked into. I just don't know what the motivation is for it yet. Because I usually just pick this up when I'm feeling like I'm having a good day. Sometimes, when I'm tired from doing other stuff, I'm like, I could sit down and stream for a couple hours. Much better than getting up and doing manual labor and things like that. That's the way I roll. My name is Aero. I enjoy playing Clash Royale a great deal. Streaming it for you guys is a lot of fun. Having actual interaction back is amazing because, I could sit here and play games and it would be fun. It would be fun enough. But interaction and talking and having a good time and making jokes and, having fun, that's what I'm honestly here for. It's the best thing about doing this is that I have the live chat and I've got my clan and we've got people talking. And, so you're not just sitting here by yourself going, I'm going to beat this next guy. Oh, it's a mortar. I'm going to have to sit here for the next 4 minutes and play against this guy. You're just like, hey, at least we can talk just the most nasty stuff we can say about mortars while we're doing it. Makes it better. Makes it more fun. But yeah, am I going to do another one today? I probably won't do another one today, but I will probably do two tomorrow. I plan on doing like a morning one and then probably an afternoon one. But yeah, I'm going to have, I'm going to hop off for now. As I said, I'll do morning one tomorrow. I'll probably do afternoon one. Morning one probably will start around 10 o'clock, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Right now it's 5 o'clock for me. So if you're not good with Eastern Standard Time and stuff like that, that's just your point of reference. And we'll have a good time with it. Anybody else that wants to do, anything specific, please leave comments in the videos. If you do that, I have time to prepare. I do this live. I'm not like, putting together videos. I'm not editing and things like that. So, in order for me to put on something that's entertaining and not just like terrible, I have to take a little bit of time to actually think about what I'm doing before I do it. So that's why if you want me to play a specific deck, leave it in a comment. I'll put together the deck and laugh maniacally at myself at how bad I play it for a while. So that's just basically the ground rules for how I like to play. If you guys have anything specific, as I said, leave it in comments and you'll more than likely see a response from me because I almost always respond to everything. You guys have a good day. I'll see you tomorrow. Have a nice day. Bye.